And we are back for Cat Quest. Last time, we became a notorious criminal in Markarth. And now we are stepping into the forgotten, into some forgotten ruins. Sorry, doll. I need these valuables. Okay, I don't really just roll with it. I'll give a. Oh wait, Adari already has the crown, or circlet, I guess.
That's close enough.
Cassia.
Who are you?
I'm Casey. I got your letter.
Oh, it's you. I'm so glad you're here. Look, I don't know how much time we have left. My brother went down this shaft a few days ago, and I'm worried.
Yeah, even if he did survive the fall, he would have probably died from dehydration. But there is some water.
It could be dangerous, but. If anyone can do it, it's you. Now, are you ready?
All right, I'm ready.
I knew I could count on you. Now, quickly, go!
All right. Dusty journal.
If you are reading this, you stand at the entrance to an ancient dwarven city. No doubt you have never heard of it, for in all my travels and all my study, I have never read of it in any text, save for the inscription here. It reads, those who seek refuge will find peace here, basking in the sun under the ground. Those who seek gold will find riches beyond imagining, but will pay for this folly with their lives, for there is no return to the world of man.
Huh.
Is it possible there is life out here? Is it possible the dwarves are still alive after all this time? As I stand here on the precipice, war raging all over Tamriel, my mind is made up. Today, I take a leap of faith. Beloved reader, perhaps one day you will join me. Consider this an invitation or a warning.
Metellus, 11, Sun's Dawn, 4th Era, 190. All right. Get the brothers. Just my homies, anyway. Where's Forgotten City from the way out? Must be his body. Nothing too much of interest in there. Maybe I don't need to pull my sword out. The Forgotten City. Ah, jeez, my leg hurts. Oh, shit, I forgot to do my load of laundry on my chores. Guess I'll do it after our recording. But of course. How long has this place been abandoned for? I assume for a long time. Just check and see if that thing's still out there. Search the old man's body. Suicide note. Dear
to whoever reads this, I am so sorry you had to find me like this. And worse, that you will share my fate. I have spent a lifetime in this place, going around and around in circles, searching for a way out. There are only two choices. Death or the door to the house on the lake. I made the mistake of opening that door. I thought I could help them if I found the right one, but whatever I did, it took me right back to that lake house. In the end, all I learned is that some things are worse than death. I urge you to learn from my mistakes. Best to take your own life now, and find out what awaits you beyond that door. I've locked it and hidden the key. I'll guard it with my eternal soul if I have to. But I fear even that will not be enough. For the lake house calls to you. And when it does, you must not listen. Audrius.
Oh, Jinx with the old guy. That old man, that guy's disembodied voice. I don't know how long this place has been abandoned for. Maybe this is the way out of the Forgotten City. Go to the lake house. But I'll have to be careful. I think that's a portal. I think it's supposed to be a portal or something. Into this? Oh wait, as Rochelle would say from Left 4 Dead 2, I can make sense of this. We're screwed. Wow. And big dwarven ruins like Black Reach just take your breath away, don't they? I wonder what terrible thing happened here. It must have been somewhat recent. After all, that letter's from about 20 years ago, I think. Yeah, about 22 years ago. Citadel. Maybe we'll find a way out of these forgotten ruins.
I was in your shoes once, a lifetime ago. I remember the way the lake house calls to you.
This is just, we're in deep shit, people. We're in deep shit right now. But I'll have to see if they're as good as dwarven gauntlets, armor rating 15, steel plate gauntlets 16. Besides, steel's more readily available.
Have a real look. Fine, let's trade then.
We must find. We'll find more friends to take. We'll find more interesting people to take on our travels. There doesn't seem to be a good place to look in here. Whoa. Oh, the helmet isn't flowing anymore. All right. Wrong way. Who are these people? There's no way they could have been the dwarves. Altrius and Weird like that. One more auto blade. I'll have to make sure to keep that blade safe. This here blade of mine safe. And the guards will probably just keep it in the evidence chest. Then I'll have to pull another big heist. And I think I've already had my fair share of those. This seems like the way to go, since the lights are randomly... Lasers are lit
randomly. I thought to myself, do I want to die in here alone? Or do I want to open that door?
What the... I shall deal with whatever thing is in here. Probably definitely a ghost.
It seems like a simple choice. And yet, in the end, death was the better option all along.
Wow. This is getting heavy. Supposed to follow where the lights are going. Where are the lights going? I don't know how much the healing potions are, but if they like expired or whatever. That's a knife. This just makes me sad. Wait. Am I even going the right way? Or is it just me randomly walking around in circles? Oh, on the Citadel balcony. Oh, I gotcha. There's okay, I'll stop being all edgy. Maybe this is the way to the balcony. I can't tell. I just want to find a way out of the city. Click the balcony. But... just a wild goose chase just running around this labyrinth of a citadel. Okay. Not screw it. I'm sorry, but it must be done. Yeah. I don't understand. Maybe it's on the lower levels or something. Or even is something. This is just making me mad right now. I think I'm making some headway. Is this? No. Come on. I'm trying to look. I'm sorry that I have to use noclip, but it's just getting real frustrating. Or is this just a glitch? No, it isn't. I don't even see a way here. Okay. I got to turn this thing off. Let's roll. This ghost. Big house key. Oh my God! Blood charge on her. Damn it, I could have done that! Wait a minute, is there like a something piercing through, but I don't know, I'll have to check. I could just fly out of here, but I know that's not possible because Skyrim. Oh! I just crashed into one. Mushroom field, a tent. All right, let's go. It's the only way out of this damn city.
Seven years ago, I discovered this wondrous city uninhabited. Others soon followed, heeding my invitation. The community grew and prospered under my rule. But as I write this, I am alone once again, for my subjects have been the victims of an unspeakable atrocity. This is why, at the expense of my own life, I must open a portal that will take you into the past, before all this began. Beloved reader, you must go back, investigate what set this atrocity in motion, and prevent it by any means necessary.
Aromatellus. Some Back to the Future little shit right now. And yes, I know all the time travel plot's a little shoehorned in maybe, but hey, at least better than the whole
"it was all a dream"
kind of bullshit. That's what people do.
To introduce me to your strapping new friend, Galvar.
We're on our way to see the yard. It'll be time for you to get your claws into the fray.
Welcome to our city.
I look forward to
your
spoken. You should come for a drink at my tavern, Holy Sentinel, tonight. Just about everyone's there after dark.
Be careful of the first girl, she... Well, it's not my place to say. There's enough gossip in this place as it is. It's a small city, after all. Only 24 of us at the moment. 23 if you don't count Brandis, who's halfway to the next life. Loki's barely managing to keep him alive.
Very strange.
Take it easy.
I was so nervous.
I was just showing our new friend here to the yard.
Well, how about you get back to work, and I take our new friend the rest of the way. If you don't work, none of us eat, Gulver. Remember that.
How could I forget?
Fine, I'll get back to work.
It was nice meeting you, my friend. You stop by for a chat anytime you like.
I'm sorry about that. That probably sounded a bit harsh, but it's my job to make sure we all have enough to eat. I'm Jormund. Let's head up to the next floor then, shall we? Stay close behind me. Wouldn't want you getting lost now, would we?
I wonder what atrocity happened. Well, I said it was unspeakable, so I won't speak about it.
Haven't had any new arrivals in a while. Seems Marius. But he mostly keeps to himself. Bit secretive, actually.
It's actually really strange. See, it says 4th Era 201. But it's supposed to take place. This quest mod is supposed to take place during year 194 of the 4th Era. Kind of more immersive if they change the date.
No crime, no conflict. Most people don't even bother locking the doors.
I kind of like the fairy.
You could steal someone without breaking the dwarves' law. It's not as if you could sell it to anyone here.
You wouldn't want to keep the Jarl waiting, would you? You do that.
Okay, that guy's a bit of a jerk. Alright, Jormund, let's go. You doing good, Grandma? Jormund. Man, this is taking a while for him to do a thing. So I'm just gonna push on. Gaia.
Oh, welcome. I'm Gaia. You come and say hello when you're free.
Always got her who was buried in a book, that one. Helps out Brawl down in the city. Our resident expert about the history and laws of the Dwemer. Last I heard, they were trying to track down some dwarven artifacts. Should ask Brawl about it, if you're into that sort of thing. This is the Citadel kitchen. Remember to be polite to our cook, Asanchi. She does her best with what she has, which isn't much.
You really should go and see the Jarl before we talk.
Okay. Alright, Jormund, let's go. Where's there any Khajiit or Argonians in this city? And if it's possible, I'll probably marry Daria. Or a mod where you get to marry Sadia.
First, he was the first one here. Well,
all right, let's see.
Anyway, so the Citadel is his, and where are all his guests? Second, he's very protective of this place, and won't tolerate anyone disturbing the peace. So be on your best behavior, and you should be fine.
Okay. All right, Jormund man. Let's see. Can we just hurry it up already? Oh good, Gorman can keep him. Keep up.
This is the top of the Citadel.
Wait, hang on guys. Okay, anyways.
The bathhouse is off limits. And I'm not even sure what's behind the gold door. Only the Jarl has ever gone in there. You're on your own from here. I've got lazy farmers to supervise.
The Jarl is waiting for you on his balcony, on your left.
Well, you're a guide to Jarl Metellus. I'd always imagined like someone named Metellus would be a dark elf, but I'm guessing he's an Imperial. That's my guess. Soul trap, school, torch plug in a jar. Just trying to look at everything. But I don't even want to steal anything right now. There's already been one big heist in the last episode. Okay. Where's Mr. Metellus?
Mr.
tell us?
There's a face I don't recognize. Uh-huh. Welcome to my city. I'm Jarl Metellus. Tell me, what is your name? It's always exciting to meet a new member of our small community. Now, before I forget, since you're here for good, you'll need some quarters. Here's a key to the last vacant chambers down in the city, between Brawl and Luki. It's all yours. Now tell me, what brings you to my city? I sent you here. I'm not sure what you mean.
Here's a letter.
Well, let's see.
Let me guess, will this cause a time paradox?
This is my handwriting. The victims of an unspeakable atrocity. I will open a portal that will take you into the past. You must go back. This is real, isn't it? I've even toyed with the idea of creating a portal between two points in time, with Brawl's help. But that's odd. My letter makes no mention of what caused the disaster. I suppose I was in a hurry. So tell me, what's going to happen to us? That's exactly what I saw when I first discovered this place several years ago. It seems whatever happened then is going to happen again. I think it has something to do with the dwarves' lore. This is bad. This is very, very bad.
Oh no, man.
Yes.
Dwarves.
You see,
I know
the dwarves
who
built this place left inscriptions. Brawl hasn't been able to fully translate, but we understand some parts. This warning keeps coming up. The many shall suffer for the sins of the one. We think that breaking the law here will cause some kind of event. The truth is, I've used the dwarf law to frighten my people into obedience. And it's worked so far. But someone's about to break that law. Let me think. Your arrival here is exactly what I need. You've helped me a great deal by bringing this note to my attention. I wonder if you could do me another favor. I need you to investigate the city, talk to my people, help them. If it'll win their trust, you can even go through their possessions if you have to.
I don't think I should do that.
You must work out who is going to break the dwarves' law. Once you have a name, come back and tell me immediately. As Jarl, I authorize you to go anywhere you need to go, including private homes. But if someone asks you to leave, you should do so immediately.
The fate of the city rests in my hands.
I can't promise either of those things, but I will certainly do everything within my power to help you once you've helped my people. And of course, if you decide to stay, I would make sure you
Well, I think I'd prefer life on the surface.
Life here. Now, what do you say? Will you help me?
Yes.
Thank you. Now, you mustn't tell anybody.
You know, maybe I'll load up a previous save file and see what happens if I do break the law.
People do foolish things when they panic. If it helps you, you're welcome to borrow the book on my desk. It contains the names and addresses of my subjects. Just don't show it to anyone.
Okay.
Goodbye for now, and good luck. I don't need to tell you what will happen if you fail.
Alright, everyone. Looks like if we actually break the law here, it'll cause an apocalypse or something right now. My guess is like the sun will just... The alleged underground sun thing will just go batshit and burn everyone alive. Most likely destroy the city. Where is his personal book? Oh, no. I'm not stealing from anything. Nothing. Let's see here. Take this. Anyways, Brawl. Let's see here. Brawl. quarters, city northwest of the northwest chambers. Roll research, general blah blah blah. Gaius, quarters is the lower floor. Room 3, assigned role, research assistance, blah 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 blah. Deceased, of course. Research assistant to Brawl. Dabble in the garden. Last seen entering the palace. Door behind him. Presumed dead. Golvar, I know him. Hey, he's not lazy, he's a nice man. Vitus, Jormund, Harabal. Courier Herald looks found key. Dooley. Sforcher. Rastasia. And Shani, whatever. Demidas, Safria. Sato. Vernon. Lukey. Oren. Micey. Jeshel. Yismar. There's a lot of dudes. Oh! I'm in here! Just passed in my lake house. Oh no, I've already broken a goddamn law. When? I'm gonna do something. Okay, no. I'll probably make a separate video of what will happen. For now, that'll have to do it for this episode. See you guys later.